Hi, good morning.
Good morning, I'm Miss Penny, and these are the KidVision Kids, and we're here today to find out about the rainforest.
Well, welcome. My name is Miss Sarah, and you guys are in the perfect place. In fact, this is the only garden in the United States where we can grow a rainforest outside. Raise your hand if you think the rainforest is important. Perfect. Everybody take a deep breath in. And out. All of this amazing air that you're breathing, these trees are constantly making for us. And in the rainforest, we have a lot of trees. In fact, we sometimes call the rainforest the lungs of the earth because they're making air for us all the time. Plus, we've got lots of different plants, lots of different animals that live in the rainforest. So do you think that might be pretty important to learn about?
Yeah.
Excellent, well, let's go.
Ray, come on, kids.
All right, so we are going to look at some leaves now. So what is one thing you notice right here about this plant? Yes, sir.
It's shaped like a heart.
It's shaped like a heart, right? Did everybody notice that right away?
Yeah.
This plant is shaped like a heart for a reason. So we're talking about the rainforest. So what do you think we have a lot of in the rainforest?
Rain.
We have lots of rain in the rainforest. So imagine you're a plant and you're getting hit and hit and hit with rain, right? Imagine your hand was a leaf. And take your other hand and be the rain coming down. And you're hitting it over and over and over again, right? What's gonna happen? It might break if you're a leaf. So I am going to be the rain. And see if you can observe what happens to the water as it's hitting this leaf. The water is actually coming down and it's going down towards the plant's roots. This is called a drip tip because off of this tip, the water drips. Perfect. Do you guys want to go on a plant scavenger hunt to see if you can find some plants in the rainforest?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Build a plant. I'll tell you the job of each plant part and you guess what it is. What helps anchor the plant in the ground, drinks water, and gets nutrients from the soil? Roots. What part holds the plant up and helps move water and nutrients to different parts of the plant? Stem. What part uses sunlight, water, and air to make the plant's food? Leaves. What part is bright, smells good, and attracts pollinators like bees and butterflies? Flower. The next two parts go together. What grows new plants if you put it in the ground? A seed. What part hugs around the seed to protect it? A fruit. Good job.
So in the rainforest, there are actually four different layers. So way down here at the forest floor, everybody go down, way down to the forest floor. Way down to the forest floor. Down at the forest floor, it's very dark and there's not a lot of sunshine. There's not even a lot of rain down here because we're so far down. Now as you start to grow up a little bit, in the understory layer, you start to have a little more space and you have a lot of bugs flying around. You have some birds and bats. But there's still not a lot going on because it's so dark down here. But start to stretch out a little bit in the canopy layer. That's where most of your animals are going to live. That's where you see your monkeys and your birds and all sorts of good stuff. You're getting a little more sunlight and then stretch up all the way up to the emergent layer. That's the one that sticks way, way out at the top. Stretch as big as you can up to the emergent layer. Up there, there's a lot of rain. There's a lot of sunshine. There's a lot of wind. The only things that really like it up here are the big birds like hawks, because it's very open, so they can fly up here. In these layers, it's actually pretty crowded because all of these plants want to live together. I have some animals here who have gotten kind of lost. Do you guys think you can help me find which layer of the rainforest these animals live at?
Yeah!
Excellent. All right, so what do we have up first? Oh, where are those ants gonna go? Where do you think?
The forest floor.
Yeah, down here on the forest floor. Excellent. And what else do you have? Oh, let's see. We have a frog. So where's that gonna live? Exactly, right here where he's got enough space to kind of climb around. Ooh, and where's that agouti gonna go? It's kind of like a big rat.
It's gonna go on the forest floor.
Perfect, and this beautiful frog? Exactly, our frogs are gonna kind of live together in the middle. Next up, our tapir, where's he gonna live? Perfect, right down here on the ground with the agouti. And the beautiful macaw, where does he wanna fly? Perfect, right there, kind of in between the canopy and the emergent layer. Wonderful. Ooh, and where's that monkey gonna go? Perfect. And that beautiful bird, the quetzal. Yeah, let's give him some space to fly right up here. And last but definitely not least, where's that emerald tree boa gonna go? Perfect, where it might even be able to eat those frogs. And last but not least, the harpy eagle. Oh, so he has plenty of space to fly. Great job, guys. Give yourselves a round of applause.
Yay.
Everybody has a different home, and we've got animals that live in every single layer of our rainforest. Isn't that amazing? Oh, at the very bottom of our forest floor, we have some very special creatures, our decomposers. And we even have one down here right now already, our ants, who are starting to gather up all of those dead leaves. So we are going to go meet some of the amazing decomposers who live at the forest floor. Do you guys want to meet some decomposers?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. So a decomposer is kind of like the garbage man of the rainforest. They take all of the dead leaves and debris on the forest floor and they turn them into that wonderful rich soil that all of these plants then use to grow big and strong. Some decomposers are insects, but not all decomposers are insects. One of my favorite decomposers is the mushroom. So fungus is not an insect, but it's a great decomposer. But there are a lot of insect decomposers that we're going to find here. So snails, ants, worms, millipedes, pill bugs, grubs, slugs, beetles, spiders. They're all very important on this forest floor.